The 2018 Daytona 500 was thrilling, just like everybody anticipated before the race started. And this man goes to victory lane. Austin Dillon wins the Daytona 500 for the very first time in his career. Austin, put it into words.
There's nothing like winning here at Daytona 500. It's just, it's an amazing place.
I married a crazy woman, and her midnight dream, she woke up and told me what she wanted to do. Has turned into this. So this is Rescue Ranch.
NASCAR driver Ryan Newman likes to joke about how he and his wife Chrissy got the idea for the 177-acre animal refuge. And while Chrissy says it didn't exactly happen the way he claims, it was a dream of hers that started it all, a dream to make a difference in the lives of unwanted animals.
All the athletes participating in the Drive for Diversity Pit Crew Combine know the recruiting process. They have been through it before in sports like football and basketball. Jeremy Kimbrough was a star linebacker for Appalachian State. He even spent a season and a half with the Washington Redskins of the NFL. He was looking for a new challenge.
You know, it's just really a blessing from God to be able to give me another chance to be able to use my athleticism.
Side by side out of turn four, here come Harvick and Kyle Busch.
The great thing about radio is you get to paint the picture.
Harvick, though, gets out of shape. Kyle Busch will lead lap number two.
We have to create something that you can visualize in your mind.
And Brad Keselowski is collecting this crash.
Let's check in now with Brad Gilley.
This is after the race started and they had a hole punched in the nose.
Some of the NASCAR on Fox crew hoping to get on a roll at this bowling event to celebrate Fox's 15th year of showing the Daytona 500. Two-time winner Michael Waltrip isn't the greatest bowler in the house, he will admit to that, but he is sure entertaining interviewing the drivers right before the start of each race.
Hey, Vinny Hamlin, Michael Waltrip, Fox Sports. Have you seen Bryson Burns? He has a suitcase with $1 million in it.
No, but if I find him, I'll introduce myself to him.
It's cool that the drivers play along with you. I mean, they're 30 minutes away from going, but they play along with you.
Yeah, you see that, right? It's interesting whether it's Dale Jr., Kevin Harvick, Jimmy Johnson, whoever it is, when I come up to them and it's all impromptu, like they don't know I'm coming, they're always nice to me.
NASCAR wives aren't just supportive of their husbands. Lots of them have plenty of talents of their own.
So you're going to teach me how to do this?
Teaching an old dog new tricks isn't easy, but Haley Dillon, wife of NASCAR's Ty Dillon, gave it her best when trying to teach me how to frost and decorate a cake.
I like to kind of put like a mound in the middle.
For Haley, the talent runs in her family.
My grandma made wedding cakes for 40 years.
Oh,
she still
really?
Does, yes. She is incredible at it.
Ray Wright, a pit crew member for the 27 team, is the mastermind behind Pit Stops for Poverty. They made their first donation to the Second Harvest Food Bank of Northwest North Carolina in June of last year and have donated $50,000 to date.
This is not roughing it compared to what most people have to go through that are struggling to get their meals every night. But we're trying to do a little bit just to raise some awareness, and we're going to have a good time doing it. And we're trying to do our part to make North Carolina a better state.
You know, when you're averaging 200 miles an hour, a lot of things move, so we do run some different braces here.
David Reagan can feel it when the guys in the Front Row Motorsports shop at Statesville have the 38 car dialed in. He'll run three races carrying the Shriners Hospitals for Children logo, a charity he supported for more than a decade.
I joined the fraternity. I'm a member of the Shriners and, you know, visit the hospitals, invite some patients and their families out to the racetrack.
Kevin Conley and I completed the Richard Petty driving experience, and I needed lots of encouragement.
Slow team, team slow. All right. We'll see who has the slower lap time.
Yes. All right, contest, who can go slower?
She's going to go faster than
No me. Way.
Yeah. Oh.
I was really nervous.
Are you ready?
Oh,
get
my gosh, no.
Brave
so scared. Oh.
This is happening. You ready?
Oh, I'm so scared. So this is actually what I'm the most excited about, the clothes. Like, wearing one of these racing suits, it's really cool. You know, driving the race car, I'm not so excited to do that.
I'm the first African-American to ever pit for Richard Childress Racing, ever.
Darrell Edwards made his own history when he was offered a position with RCR after an internship in his senior year at High Point University.
From cleaning tires, to taking out trash, to mopping floors, cleaning gyms, whatever it takes to show those guys that I really wanted to be here.
Recently, we went up to Stuart, Virginia to check it out.
There are some vintage race cars and plenty of classic photos inside the Wood Brothers old race shop in Stuart, Virginia. There's also a 1960-style slot car racetrack, which is the pride and joy of Eddie Wood and his brother Len.
Yeah, I could come over here by myself and just run it for, you know, for hours.
Went behind the scenes with the radioactive producer to show us how it's all put together.
Tell you what, this place is packed today.
Talladega was a great race.
Green flag.
It had the crashes, had the passes for the lead, and then it had a first-time winner. So the great thing about Radioactive is the behind-the-scenes, the footage and the scanner sounds that you don't get on the normal Sunday.
Radioactive airs on Fox Sports 1's Race Hub.
All right, and it is also posted on the NASCAR Facebook and YouTube pages every Tuesday evening.